Hi, I'm Olena, and today I'll be talking a little bit about how we build e-commerce inside the Webflow. So a little bit about myself. I'm a software engineer at Webflow. For the last year, I was involved in such project as creating data manager for e-commerce, e-commerce settings, and currently I'm tech leading and also working as part of the e-commerce variant project. If to talk about the e-commerce feature at all, it's actually is kind of like umbrella feature, because inside this one feature, there are many small features that were built as separate projects, like Stripe setup, product manager, product page, product variants, checkout, out-of-tax calculation, customizable emails, and many others that are even not included in this slide. And it was all built through last year by all these amazing people. You even can see Kyle in the top left. And let's go back for our topic, creation e-commerce inside the Webflow. And I'll try to tell you a few and exactly the three interesting stories that have happened through last year with me inside creation of this feature. And first story will be named Five Ducks and the Product Data Manager. So Product Data Manager was one of the first features that were created for the e-commerce. And the first iteration of the UI for this feature has looked like this. If you look at it quite closely, you can see, oh, actually, I've already seen this UI, and it quite resembles a CMS data manager. And let's go to the concept that is named duck typing. Who is familiar with this concept? OK, at least you will learn something from this event. It can be expressed in a very simple quote. If it walks like a duck, and if it quacks like a duck, it probably is a duck. So if a product management for the e-commerce looks kind of familiar and it looks like a CMS data manager, probably we can build everything like using everything that was existing before in CMS data manager. As if it walks like a duck and it quacks like a duck. It should be a duck. Or can it be a duckling? Or can something look totally different but still be a duck? So the hard question that we have while we were working on this project was, okay, it's quite our e-commerce data manager quite resembles the CMS data manager, but there is a big difference between them. And the main difference wasn't in the UI. The main difference was how the data is connected to the UI. I'll try to explain you how it works inside the Webflow. So this is how CMS data manager is built. For one item edit form, there is only one item on the data level that corresponds to this item edit form. Even in the first iteration for the e-commerce data manager, things look different. As for one product item edit form, two items were corresponding to this form. One was product item and one was SKU item. Product item contains the data that is related to the product, like product name, product description. And SKU item is containing information that is related to some variation of the product. What is actually like SKU item? If we have a shirt or t-shirt, it can be small, medium, large. It can also be white, green, black. Okay, and SKU is containing information that is related to only this one variation, like for small green t-shirt. We created this from the start like this because we were dreaming big and wanted to be able in the future to add possibility to add variants for the product. The second variation of the e-commerce data, the second iteration for the e-commerce data manager look even more complex. If to talk about how data is related to this product item edit form, as for one item edit form, already three sources of truth were needed. One of them corresponds to product data, one of them corresponds to SKU data, and one of them was responsible to SKU inventory data that is stored separately. And you can already imagine that things are becoming even more complicated when there are variants included in the product. So here is like very schematic view how a data level for the product that has 9 variants look like. So we have in here 19 source of truth for one product edit form. This deep diving allows us to see that even though that from time to time things can be look quite similar, there are actually this difference. And even though that if the same UI, it's hard to spot this difference, When we spot it and when we see deeply about them, we can understand how it should be different and actually how to build this feature better for the future. I hope that one of the main lessons that we learned from here is that we should dream in big about our futures and features. And when we see that something is similar, we also should ask ourselves, maybe something also is different, and how these things that are different should interfere our decision how to build this feature. Second story is named How to Start from the End. So, a little questions to you. And I will put even inspiration slide for you here. What is the most important part of any online store? You can go loud, like, not whispering.
Sales?
Very near, but what is even more important? Getting paid, okay. Very, very warm and close. Between checkout, pay, and in. This name is, this word is even on this slide.
Ease of use.
Payment, but payment requires us. What to have?
Orders,
yeah. Why your clients or you yourself, if you are thinking about creating store for yourself, are actually creating the store? Because you want to have possibility to accept online orders. Without having orders, yeah, you can have beautiful products online, but no orders, no payments, no anything. So actually, any person that is creating stores online just wants to see this. Oh, orders are coming. Let's talk a little bit about this feature orders. So you already remember this slide from the like a few minutes before I have shown it. This is a list of all features that at some point we were thinking to include in the e-commerce. But frankly speaking, if we look deeper, it shouldn't be a list. It should be something like this, where you can see how features are dependent on each other and what feature we can start to build if previous was built. For example, we can't start working on the inventory management if product management wasn't built, because we need to place somewhere else this information for this product, and we need this product item to exist. Similar to the checkout. No person will be possible to do the checkout for the physical product if there are no shipping rules, because, okay, you order, but there are no shipping possibility to pay for the shipping, and it just do not work. Let's look out how orders, what we need to do to enable order feature to be created. So we need to do to create product management from us, then we need to work on the product list from the developer perspective to add this feature to the e-commerce. And then we need to, we as software engineer need to work on the add to cart component and cart component. And then we are working on the checkout. And then finally, we would be able to start work on the order management. It's all true, but we actually inside the team wanted to go uncomfortably fast. As we know that many people out there are waiting when beta for the e-commerce will start. And you probably was among those people that were just waiting when. And we feel this, and we feel this feeling of urgency and wanted to do this incredibly fast. How it's possible to do something faster than it was planned and it's logically available? One of the ways is to add more people. But if you even add more people to the project that is designed like this, it wouldn't help because some feature creation is blocked. And if it's blocked, you can't do anything. You can put how many people you want. It doesn't help. In ideal world, we would want something like this. So we can start work on any feature, no matter where it is in the like logical part of the e-commerce journey. And we found out that quite useful is fake it until you make it phrase. Have you heard of it? Yeah, I see nods, yeah. Probably as a designer, you are quite confident with this feature in the lorem ipsum format. Without this fake it until you make it, it was possible to create this one UI, like the tab in the editor. But we are not possible to start working on the order list view or to start working on the separate order view. So we just had this magical button in the admin panel that you can press, and everything was created for you in from the data perspective. And on one project where e-commerce was enabled, you have every needed data in the format that was expected from the order. So it unblocked us possibility to start working on the UI and behavior of the order list, and as well as the separate order view. Even more, actually order feature was created one of the first in e-commerce, even before checkout, add to cart, and cart component. My main takeaway from this story is do not allow anything to stop you, because you can always fake it until you make it, and no one probably will even notice. And the third and the last story is about two ways. So as I was working on this feature for a year, and I love reading, I read a lot of books, and one of them was this, The Manager Path. And in the chapter, Ruling with Fear, Guiding with Trust, was this example with two managers. One manager was named Camille, and second manager was named Michael. You even can notice that Camille is author of this book. So, what was the difference between these two managers? When something unpredictable happened, unexpected, or even failure, Camille had reacted with anger. She was annoyed. And what it leads to is that her team stopped trying hard because they were afraid to fail. And in contrary, Michael had reacted different to the situation. Instead of getting tense or angry, he gets curious when things don't seem to be going well. So let's took both this manager and to look to some situations that have happened for us inside the e-commerce project. Not a failure, but something unexpected. So there was this feature, shipping settings for shipping zones, where you can add new shipping zone and set some countries for it and add methods that are available for these countries. And this feature creation started with only one person in the front-end team. It was me. But after some time, thankfully, Tommy has joined me. The unexpected thing about this situation was that even Tommy has joined me in the team, we delivered this feature in exact same time when I predicted I will deliver it alone. If we look to this situation through Camille's eyes, we can say, adding more people will actually slow down the process. But I propose you to look to this situation through Michael's eyes and ask ourselves, adding more people will actually slow down the process, and get curious about the situation, what actually have happened. A little dive in, if you are not quite familiar how developers' process look like in the Webflow, creation of any features in simple way looks like this. One developer is adding code, second developer is code reviewing code, and also design review happens, and after these two steps are passed, this code is going to the testing. So let's get curious about the situation. What have happened when I was alone in the team? Okay, I have added code, but I actually asked for code reviews from people from others' team. And when Tommy joined me in the team, we started asking for the code reviews from each other. And the truth is that from time to time, code reviews can take the same amount of time as creating the feature. So actually, nothing has slowed down. This time for the code reviews was just hidden in the situation when I was alone in the team and was included in the time of the project when we were two in the team, because we weren't like wasting time of the people from other teams. So as you see, if you look to the situations through the Michael eyes, we can see what actually have happened and what were the reasons for this. So my main takeaway from the story is get curious. It's never hurts, at least. But get curious, because you can understand what have happened inside the situation, understand what were the causes, and even more can learn from the situation and predict better the future and how to act in this situation in the future. So I hope that even though my talk was about the e-commerce and how we built it inside Webflow, you also have learned something that you can reuse for no matter what project are you currently working on. Dream big about your project, do not allow anything to stop you, and get curious every time when unexpected happened. nearly the right timing. Like, two last slides. So, I want to thank for all our customers, for you, for our users, because this year was challenging and hard in some situation, and my main emotional charger was just to go to Twitter to look up what our users are saying about Webflow and recharge my emotional battery, because it's so awesome to read every time how excited are people about using Webflow, how excited are people about e-commerce beta. 150 replies in the forum. And it's so good to that you are part of our journey in the Webflow. You are the reason we exist. You are the reason that we are creating e-commerce and other features. Thank you.